You have to follow the same procedure for all the machines, how you follow, like receiving the patient, ruling out the contraindication, checking the area for treatment, ruling the local contraindications, general contraindications, then assembling your equipments. Usually for TENS, you need the standard things like carbon rubber electrodes, then the covers, water, kidney tray, some straps for tying, and the machine, gel. If you are using gel, then only gel, water is not needed. Water may be needed to decrease the skin resistance, but not needed to dip your covers on the inside the water. So when you want to apply the TENS onto the patient body, there are several methods of application. One, pain point application means wherever the pain is there, you keep electrode on that, whether it is positive or negative, you keep the electrode on that. Then please note down these types of applications. I will show you the settings later. So there are different types of applications. One, pain point. For example, if patient comes and says, I have here pain, this is the pain point. So you keep directly your cathode there, okay, and anode on the opposite side or any other place. This is one type of application. The second one is acupuncture type of application. That means for chronic pain, if the pain is there from many months, like 3 months, 4 months, say 5 months, from past many months if the pain is there, that time you have to keep the electrodes one above and one below the pain. For example, if the same is the acupuncture kind of pain, chronic pain from many days it is there, then you keep one electrode below, one electrode above. Above cathode, below anode. Like that you keep the placement for chronic pains. The first one is acute pain. Some acute pain where there is a trigger point for the pain. Another kind of application is dermatomal application. Dermatomal application means, for example, if a patient has problem in the C8, okay, C8 region is the pain. So you keep the TENS electrodes on the C8 dermatome. Where is the C8 dermatome? The C8 dermatome, this is C6, C7, C8. This area is the C8 dermatome. So you keep the electrodes on the C8 dermatome for the pain which is there in the neck and which is radiating to the pain area. Okay? So this is dermatomal application.
Pain here.
Yeah.
And put here.
Put one electrode here, one electrode in the pain area.
Cathode
in the pain area. Yeah. Cathode in the pain area, anode in the dermatomal area. So this is majorly used for referred pains which are coming from spine to the dermatomes. Similarly, if the patient has L5, okay, L5 lumbar L5 segment pain which is coming to the leg, okay, here like L5 is where, you know, L5 is, this is L4, this is L5, the skin area which supplied by the L5 dermatome is here. So you keep one electrode on the lumbar spine, one electrode on the L5. Yes. This is for referred pains or dermatomal applications.
This is if pain come from
there,
L5 to
here.
Okay.
Okay. Now, next, if the pain is located in one region, like cervical region, lumbar region, or any of the spinal region, any of the dermatome, any of the nerve roots are compressed and causing the pain, then you will apply parallelly to the spine. For example, if cervical spine is the pain, any of the dermatomes are the nerve roots are compressing, then you keep one electrode on that side of the spine, one electrode on this side of the spine. Okay, parallel application for the spine, wherever there is the pain. Another one is nerve pain. Okay, the nerve, you know, nerves, radial nerve, ulnar nerve, median nerve. So, which if the nerve is causing the pain, then you have to keep the areas where the nerve is superficial. For example, if the radial nerve is pain in the upper limb, radial nerve is superficial in the back of the hand. You know, radial groove, the radial groove will be there, their radial nerve is superficial. You keep one electrode on the radial groove, other electrode on the dorsum of the forearm. These are the two places where radial nerve is superficial. Next one is, if it is ulnar nerve, okay? Ulnar nerve is superficial here, okay? This place is the superficial point for ulnar nerve. So you keep one electrode on the ulnar nerve and one electrode on the ulnar aspect of the hand, anywhere, ulnar side. Next one is median nerve. When median nerve is having problem, you keep one electrode on the again the medial aspect of the arm and one on the medial aspect of the lateral aspect of the forearm. So this is for median. Similarly, if there is a sciatic nerve which is painful, then you keep it one on the buttock, one on the posterior aspect of the leg. If it is common peroneal nerve, you keep it on the femur, you keep it on the fibula and dorsal aspect of the foot. If it is tibial nerve, then you keep it on the popliteal fossa and posterior aspect of the calf. So these are the areas where that particular nerve is superficial. So whenever it depends upon the nerve, if the nerve is problem, then you keep it on the nerve wherever it is superficial. So if it is a joint, for example, elbow joint, wrist joint, if joint is problem, then you can take four electrodes or two electrodes, keep it around the joint. It is elbow, you keep one, so around the joint, wrist on the joint, knee on the joint, okay, ankle on the joint. So if there is a joint pain, you keep the electrodes around the joint. So it depends upon the area of treatment, the type of muscle, the type of tissue which is involved, acute pain, chronic pain, nerve, depends upon the placement of the electrodes will change. If the bigger area you want to cover, then you use two channels, four electrodes. Smaller area you want to cover, you take one channel and two electrodes. Depends upon what is the problem, you can choose the number of electrodes, number of channels. Clear? So now, just I will show you an example of how to set the machine for the tens. Imagine if the patient has a pain in the wrist area, the pain is here, the wrist joint. Decrease the skin resistance of the wrist joint. So after that, take the cathode on the pain. If the patient says pain is here more, then you keep the cathode there and tie the electrodes. So depend upon the structure you are treating, the pain areas will change or lift. Okay. Put it like this. So once you keep the electrodes, go to electrotherapy. Pain management, you see biphasic pulsed current tens. So go to tens. You can choose any mode, asymmetrical, symmetrical, burst. Depends upon whether it is continuous current or modified current. Choose asymmetrical alternating. Now currently I am using only channel 1. So I select channel 1. The treatment time, you can keep maximum of 30 minutes. Electrode selection, carbon rubber electrodes. Phase duration, 100 microseconds. Frequency, here you have to change. If it is acute pain, then you will select a frequency more than 90 up to 130. If it is a chronic pain, you will choose a frequency less than 10, between 2 to 4. So this is the frequency selections you have to do. Now I have kept for chronic pain 4 hertz frequency modulation. I kept for 4 hertz, there will be changing. So start and apply the current. Can you feel? Okay, can I increase?
Yes.
Good. So now like this you can keep, depends upon the frequency you select. If it is a acute pain, you have to select a frequency of more than 90 hertz, approximately 100 hertz, and you can treat 3 to 4 times in a day. Okay, so frequency of treatment is 3 to 4 times. Every time you can apply for 30 minutes.
In a week?
No, in a day. In one day you can apply 3 to 4 times. Okay, so and every time you apply it is 30 minutes. The duration of the treatment is usually 30 minutes. That is for acute pain. If it is chronic pain, usually it is the effect of chronic pain seen after the treatment around half an hour or 45 minutes. So whenever you want to treat chronic pain, you can keep up to 45 minutes. 45 minutes, and you can keep 3 to 4 times in a day, no problem. Okay, but the when you keep acute pain strategy, that is more than 100 frequency, 100 hertz of frequency, the effect is immediate, but the effect will lose after 2 to 3 hours. Okay. But if you are treating for chronic pain, when you keep the frequency less, the frequency time is more, 45 minutes, but effect is little long lasting. Okay, but either of the cases, you can keep the, you can give the treatment 3 to 4 times a day, depends upon the need of the patient. If patient needed, then you give. Patient not needed, then you need not give. Okay, but you can give maximum up to 4 times or 3 times up in a day. So coming to the basic parameters for electrotherapy, mode of the treatment. Mode is tense, can be in high tense mode or low tense mode. High tense is for acute pain, low tense is for chronic pain. That is mode. Intensity depends upon the patient, how much they can take, how much capacity or current they can take. So usually whatever patient felt, they will keep it. If the patient says, I am feeling, because they have to keep for a long time.
Can you get again the chronic frequency?
Chronic frequency is 2 to 4 hertz.
2 to 4?
Heads. Heads means number of cycles per second. Okay? Now acute means it is 90 to 130 hertz. So
I mean how many times a day or
I'm coming. So this is mode first. Intensity is depend upon the patient, how much maximum you can increase, how many milliamperes depends upon the patient, wherever they are comfortable. The duration, time of treatment, 30 minutes for acute, 45 minutes for chronic. Frequency of treatment, how many times you can treat? You can treat 3 to 4 times per day. Okay? You can treat 3 to 4 times per day, not week, per day. Okay, and depends upon the requirement, you can decrease the sessions. For example, patient is having acute pain, very severe pain, cannot bear. You can give 4 times a day. After 2 days, 3 days, pain is decreasing, you can give 1 time a day. Each session, each set, maybe 3 hours, 4 hours, once in a 3 hours, you can keep. Because the treatment itself takes 30 minutes. The effect will be there for 2 hours after the treatment. So you can plan once in a 3 hours. Okay? So this is how usually they plan for the treatment, and these are the basic parameters. And one more type of application of electrodes, which I forgot to tell you, is application for the wound or pain. Application for the wound. I told you, you know, some new indications are there for pain. One is fracture healing, wound healing, okay, or post surgery, after the surgery healing the scar. For example, you know surgery, what is surgery?
Yes.
They cut the skin and they do something, yes? So that time if there is a surgical scar pain, so this is called as contiguous placement. If for example, if this is the surgical site, happen? If this is the area of surgery, they have done surgery like this and they have done, imagine, stitches, okay? So if this is the area, then you cannot keep directly on the surgical area, okay? It is not indicated. So you have to keep one that side of the sutures, one this side of the sutures,
okay?
So this is about in post surgical cases.
Above cathode, below anode, or
no problem. Oh, anyway,
okay.
Sometimes the incision is here, so that time no above below. One that side, one this side. That's it. Okay. Anywhere there is a surgery and there is a suture around it. One this side, one this side. You can keep the electrodes. Okay. And if there is a fracture, you know fracture?
Yes.
Bone break.
Yes.
There is a fracture. So imagine again, this is the fracture. Again, don't keep directly on the fracture. No. One down, one up, one up. Onto the fracture. Okay? If you want to increase the general circulation of that particular area. For example, diabetic people are there, where circulation for the foot is not there, not good. So if you want to improve the circulation, you can keep one distally, one proximally in that area. Okay? One distally, one proximally. Wherever you want to improve the circulation, depends upon that area, one proximally, one distally, you can keep.
Any electrodes.
Any electrodes. Okay?
And vein or nerve?
This is for improving the circulation. Improve the blood circulation. Only blood circulation, not pain. These are the three new indications. For pain, I told you all, I have told in the video already. However, you can, how and all you can keep the electrodes. Okay, after the video, I'll explain if you want. So, this is the new indication, electrode placements. So, clear?